Halo, it's Jang here with the Mega Construx CTF Arctic Warthog set. I can tell you right from the start, this is going to be a great set because it is based on stuff from Halo 3, which is factually the best Halo game ever. If you disagree with me, you are wrong. I had the Halo 3 edition Xbox 360 console, so your opinion is invalid. Let's take a look at that hog because it's not a puma. Yeah, buddy, this is nice. This really shows a very strong evolution of the Mega design for their Warthogs. Brings in some elements from the past, brings in some elements from the present, brings in some elements that they haven't included before. This looks so much better than the original Arctic Hog that they did quite some years back, one that I actually never got and probably never will, just because I dislike it so much, or I like it so little. Just looks too toyish to me. A lot of folks will probably have nostalgia for it because they got it back in its day and have added it to their collection, which is cool. It's just not for me. This is for me. This I like. This is something that I will be proud to display in room 117. Printing all around, of course, including new lines to really show up the facets of the front fenders and quarter panel parts, and also it's not really the hood, is it? The front? I don't even know what that would be. The front flap, the front slope. You know what I'm talking about. They also kind of sponged on some white onto all four tires. This is just paint. It looks good, looks appropriate. Brought in some of the good old splatter, two levels of splatter. One's like a toothbrush kind of splatter of white, and then also the fine spray of it for the snow on the windshield, the windscreen. I think that might be just a little bit too thick, but it's okay. I get it. I get what they were going for. It has the working winch on the front. You can actually pull this out down here carefully. I hope I didn't leave it too loose there, but yeah, that'll actually pull out. You can hook it onto things if you want to. It also gets nice and tight under there with the hook, so it doesn't waste a lot of space and it doesn't have the hook dragging around. Now you see the suspension action moving. That's a good thing. This is sprung suspension, kind of, in the sense that there is some resistance. There was a lot more resistance a couple days ago, I can tell you that. When I first built this, it felt more springy. This actually uses a silicone tube going across, kind of doing the work of a torsion tube, kind of, the way that it works, kind of. Or a single leaf spring. I don't know, it's a funny little thing, but it allows the whole thing to sit on the ground low, so it's not standing up like this by default. I hate those ones that are just too far off the ground. It's nice and low, but it has a little bit of resistance in there, so it doesn't feel like it's just completely loose, which also felt really cheap. Again, evolution, just improving things over time, taking the best things from different eras. They did the exact same thing on the suspension on the back. This one has the print for the rear tail lights. That's not perfect, but it's not bad. I'm sure glad to get a print rather than stickers there. Got the classic machine gun back here, which, as usual, is able to kind of rotate on axes that you don't want. That's just the old thing. If you have any of these old ones, you remember that. At least the parts have consistent clutch power nowadays, so you don't get some of these pieces that'll just slip all around and just fall down all the time. So you can pose this exactly where you want it to be. Still a little bit tough to get a Spartan back there in every single pose, but it works for some of them. The interior of this thing is vastly improved over everything that they've done before in the Warthog world, because they've got a printed center console piece, and they've got the upper, the rearview mirror little thing coming down from the roof, which is actually a printed piece as well. Dark blue colored seats in this one, and there's one more print in this that you can see from this side. It's on the simple side. That's all good. This is a retro based thing, and again, I'm happy to be able to get more prints. Overall, this is, I'd say, definitely one of the better built Warthogs that they've ever done. Not necessarily the best, but I think for its era, for its style, from the Bungie era, I think that this may be the best built one that Mega has done. It really holds itself together well. I think they got the suspension better than they have in the past. I'm pretty happy with it overall. Oh yeah, also almost forgot to point out the clips, one on either side, to hold on to some weapons. At least two weapons there. Three Spartans in the set, three Spartans can be used on the vehicle. So technically it needs one more to be perfect to hold on to all the necessary accessories for your Spartans to be able to get in, get out, and still be fully equipped. But glad to have those at all. Most of them don't have anything like that, and then you just have to store your weapons somewhere else. All three Spartans here are based on Halo 3 armor variants, with the default Mark 6 on the left, including the helmet. Dude in the middle is wearing the same armor, but just changed out his helmet. That's it, just the helmet. Went over to the Rogue side, which is a good mold here. I think they have captured the look and proportions of that thing pretty well. It's short and squat. Maybe just a little bit too different from the Mark 6 one, just visually. Part of that may be because of the properly included black liner for the visor for the Rogue one, which tends to make it look more horizontal than it would if they left that out. Just having that horizontal stripe of black just kind of plays tricks on the eyes. But I think it's pretty good. There was a definite difference between those. Everything else is the same on the armor sets for those two. But then the guy on the right switches out almost everything. He went full recon. Never go full recon. Yeah, this guy went full recon, which is cool. One thing that is kept the same between these is the back piece of the chest armor, and also the hip piece there. The legs, the lower legs, I'm not sure if they're correct. I don't remember that by heart, and I didn't look up the design of the lower legs. But you can see that it is different. I'm not sure if it's the correct one. I'm assuming it is, but it's definitely something to check. On the left is the Sentinel beam weapon, which is just done in a medium silver. It's not the brightest silver like they use for some of the Promethean stuff now. I really hate that weapon in the middle. It's the older, thin, flimsy shotgun. I'm tired of it. I never want to see that again. It just feels terrible, especially the tip of the barrel. It's just so thin. It just feels old and cheap and reminds me of old Mega Bloks. Bad old times. Then you get the smaller SMG on the right, which is perfectly fine and legit. The set also comes with the flag stand for the Dirty Blues, so you can just take that from them because they obviously don't need it. And they have a little box here, the smaller style ones, which surprisingly has a bunch of stuff in it. Not just a couple of things, but look at this. Grenades! Grenades for days! Thank you! I love the transparent plasma grenades, and then they also give you four frag grenades and three magnums. Success Guardian. Wrong Bungie game. Successful set. I like it. It really hits me right square in the middle of the fandom and the nostalgia hole in many ways. I couldn't really ask for much better out of any of this stuff. I mean, you know, little nitpicky things, small details. I'm glad that it doesn't look like that. I'm glad that it actually does sit down. I guess the material could have been a little bit better on the springy hose that they use inside of there. Sorry, I can't show you the thing because it's really buried inside of there. But, you know, to have a little bit more springiness to actually work. But again, as long as on display it looks proper, and I can still get it into an articulated pose, or if I want to have it, you know, posed up on a clear stand where it's jumping, the wheels are down, it's really all I can ask for. So that's enough of my yapping now, and it is finally your turn to yap in the comments if you'd like to. If you're going to say that Halo 3 is not the best Halo ever, you better say why. I'll be watching you. Thanks for stopping by. I'll talk to you again soon.
Faster! to shake us off.